It's about making things fair and dealing with an environmental issue. Milton Council will soon be debating whether or not to ban election signs on public property. Regional Councillor Zishan Hamid says there is a precedent for this kind of law in other municipalities.
Burlington and City of Mississauga, as well as Region of Alton, they don't allow signs on public roadways for various different reasons. Number one, it causes a lot of litter, causes line of sight issues on roadways when it literally blocks some visibility for drivers driving, causes a lot of pollution because these signs, some of them are recyclable, not all are, but they're often not recycled. They fly away, they get into ravines, they get into forests. When we have community cleanup, sometimes we find these signs lying around 2 years later. And so our understanding is that when it comes to election campaigns, people are free to put signs on private properties. They should go door knocking, talk to constituents, talk to voters, and have them post the signs, as opposed to starting sign wars on public properties. And lastly, one of the major issues, which is often overlooked, is that allowing signs on public properties that create sign wars, it favors wealthier candidates that can spend thousands of dollars buying signs. And candidates with more limited means, they then have this pressure to either bow out or raise money, or you know, instead of talk to voters, to now go out and raise money just to compete in these sign wars. So we feel that it's not entirely democratic to do things this way.
Meanwhile, some critics of this ban say it would actually hurt rather than help candidates running against wealthier ones or even incumbents. Although Hamid says it's a valid concern, history seems to suggest otherwise.
That concern came up when City of Burlington banned signs on public properties, and there was a big issue that it was a big concern that it would favor incumbents. What ended up happening is that out of entire council, only one incumbent won the re-election. Every other incumbent lost. So the fact that they banned signs, at least seemingly, either didn't make a difference at all or it hurt incumbents. Because you have to understand, as an incumbent, it's not very difficult for me to raise money and spend $5,000 on signs and just blast them everywhere. It's much harder for the new person to come in to raise tens of thousands of dollars or whatever amount of money.
Hamid also says this ban is not unlike one that is already in place.
All business signs are already banned and they get fined for it. And so it creates this, it's favoritism where politicians are allowed to do things that businesses cannot. And also keep in mind that signs are already banned on regional roads. So signs cannot go on Derry Road, they cannot go in Britannia, but they can go on Louis Saint Laurent or Main Street. So there, it also creates this thing where if you happen to be running an award where most of your constituents are taking regional roads, then you can't compete using signs. Whereas if you live in a ward where most of your constituents commute using local roads, then you can do certain things. So it's a really strange system that we have right now.
Milton Council will be discussing this motion at the October 4th council meeting. For more information, to submit your input or apply to make a deputation before council, go to milton.ca. For Halton News, I'm Melissa Candelaria.